Hello friends, I hope you are doing very good. So welcome back to your very own finance numerical MCQ series. So as you know that we have started with a MCQ series wherein you'll get 5 to 7 questions pertaining to finance, specially focused towards the numerical aspects. So today's lecture will be the second lecture of this video series, and this video series will be quite relevant for you for your upcoming RBI grade B and SEBI grade A examination. So before even jumping onto the first MCQ of this video series, let me grab this opportunity and let you know about the excellent results produced by EduTap over the past few years. So for the year 2017, we got 27 final selections in RBI Grade B and 11 final selections in NABARD Grade A. For the next year, that is 2018, we got over 70 plus final selections in RBI Grade B and 26 final selections in NABARD Grade A. For the same year, that is 2018, and with respect to SEBI Grade A examination, our results were overwhelming. Out of 84 candidates selected, 41 were from EduTap. And when it comes to IBPS Agriculture Field Officer exam, we got over 100 plus interview calls. So hope so that we get a good number of selection in this exam too. For knowing more about the courses being offered by EduTap, you can take a quick snapshot of these slides. We offer individual courses of the mentioned exams. Our individual course list includes RBI Grade B, SEBI Grade A, NABARD Grade A, RBI Assistant and IBPS Agriculture Field Officer. We even offer combo courses with respect to the mentioned examination. Our combos include RBI NABARD SEBI, RBI NABARD, SEBI RBI and NABARD SEBI. We are glad to announce the launch of our new course, that is QRE course, and this is for all banking examination. Three aspects will be specially covered in this course, and they are quantitative aptitude, reasoning ability and English. So wrapping up with the introduction part and moving on to the first MCQ of this video series, let me move on to the next slide. So as per our first question, DMart Limited has 1000 shares, okay, and has following data at the end of the year, okay. So if the CMP, that is current market price of the share, is rupees 4500, that is 4500, what is the book value of the share? So we have been given with a table of data which is associated with the given firm, that is DMart Limited, and we need to find out what is the book value of share. We are also given with 5 options. Option A says rupees 0, option B says rupees 1500, option C says rupees 15,000, option D says rupees 1,05,000, and option E says rupees 150. So clearly by reading out this question, you can arrive to a conclusion that this question is coming up from the equity valuation model and income statement and balance sheet part of the finance syllabus. So if your concepts regarding those parts are clear, this question will be a cakewalk for you. Otherwise, it might be a little difficult for you. I would really encourage you to pause this video here, solve this question with your own understanding, and then move on to the explanation section to check whether your answers are correct or not. So resuming back, let's move on to the explanation section to learn something more about this question. So moving on to the next slide. So let us first bring back our question. Okay, we have got it. So first, let us classify this table into the assets and liabilities part, wherein the cash and inventory part will go into the assets category, and accounts payable and short-term loans will come under the ambit of liability. So the first thing we have to do is to total out these two things. So first, moving with the asset side, so inventories worth 1,05,000 and cash worth 1,95,000 when added up comes out to be 3 lakh rupees. And talking about the liability sides, account payable worth of rupees 50,000 and a short-term loans worth 1 lakh when added up comes out to be 1,50,000. Now proceeding forward, the question is asking us to find out the book value of share. So as per the formula of book value is equal to asset minus liability. So whatever liabilities we have calculated, that is of account payable and short term loans, which is 1,50,000, when this value gets subtracted from the asset, which is a total of inventory and cash worth 3 lakh rupees, and the resulting part when divided by number of share, we arrive at book value of share. So now we are just left with placing the proper values in the requisite places. So with respect to this formula, when placing the values, we place asset of 3 lakhs over here, the liabilities total of 1,50,000 over here, and the number of share, that is 1,000, we place it at here. It will come out to be 1,50,000 divided by 1,000, and then we slash out these 3 zeros from numerator and denominator, and we arrive at book value of share, that is equal to rupees 150. So now that we know the answer and the formula of book value, let's move on to the question and mark our correct answer. So moving back to our question, so now we know that the book value of share is rupees 150, hence option E becomes our correct answer. So now it's time for us to move to our next question. So moving on to the next slide. So this question is an extension of the previous question. The data remains same, that is the DMart company having 1000 shares and has following data which is given in this table, and the current market price of that share is 4500. The different thing is that Here we need to calculate what is the PBV of the company. We are also given with 5 options. Option A says 30, option B says 10, option C says 20, option D says 3, and option E says 15. So in order to solve this question, it is very important for us to know the full form of PBV. So it is an abbreviative form of price to book value of a share of a company. So this question is also coming up from the equity valuation model. One hint I can give you in this question is that in the previous question, while calculating the book value, we overlooked this data of current market price, which is equal to 4500. But in this question, this data will be pretty relevant for you in order to arrive to the correct answer. So this is a simple one. Just pause this video here. Try to give an attempt to this question and then cross-check your answers in the upcoming slide. So resuming back, let's first bring back our question. Okay, we have got it. So we already know that the book value of share is rupees 150 as we have solved this thing in the previous question. So now this question is asking us what is the price to book value of a share of this company. So as we know that the price to book value is equal to current market price divided by book value of share. So placing the requisite values in the proper places here in this formula. So the current market price is 4500, we place it here. And then the book value of share, we know it from the previous question, that is rupees 150. One important point here is that here both the values have the same units, that is rupees 4500 and rupees 150. So while cancelling out, not only we cancel out the values, but we also cancel out the units too. So after that, the final resulting answer, what we arrive at, that is price to book value, it comes out to be 30. This 30 is not a value of rupees. This 30 is a value of ratio, that is 30:1. That is, whatever the value of current market price is going on in the market, it is 30 times the book value of share. I just stressed on this point just to make sure that you interpret the values of the ratios correctly. So now that we know the PBV, that is price to book value ratio of that company, DMart, is 30, and we also know the formula and the nitty gritties of interpreting the ratio. So now let's move back to our question and mark our correct answer. So now that we know that the PBV of the company is 30, so here option A becomes our correct answer. So it's time for us to move to our next question. So let's move on to the next slide. So as per our third question, IDFC First Limited have a PAT of rupees 180 crore in a financial year 2018-19, okay. And they have a preference dividend payable of rupees 30 crore, okay. If total number of share issued are 1 crore in quantity and the market price of share is rupees 2250, we need to calculate the EPS. And we have also been given with 5 options. Option A says rupees 150 crore, option B says rupees 150, and option C says rupees 1.5 crore, option D says rupees 0.15 crore, and option E says data insufficient. So in order to solve this question, we need to at least know the full form of these two parts, that is PAT and EPS. PAT signifies the profit after tax and EPS signifies earning per share. So this question is clearly coming out from the equity valuation model, and if you know the concepts right, this question will definitely be an easy one for you. So pause this video, give it a try, and then cross-check your answers in the upcoming slide. So resuming back, let's move on to the explanation section to learn something more about this question. So moving on to the next slide. So let's first bring back our question. Okay, we have got it. So this question is asking us to calculate what is EPS. So before even calculating the EPS, let's understand what exactly earning per share means. So basically, EPS shows how much money a company is making or generating for each share. So as you know that any company would have issued a lot of shares. In this case, the total number of shares issued are 1 crore. So what is an earning which is made by a company or generated by a company versus each share? This is what corresponds to EPS. A higher value of EPS simply indicates that there is more value to share because per share the value of earning is more, and hence investors are willing to pay more for each share because company is earning huge profits. And when we need to calculate this EPS, the formula goes like PAT minus preferential dividend, that is profit after tax minus the preference dividend, and this resulting quantity is then further divided with total number of issued shares. Now only the simple things are left. Let's place the requisite values in the proper places in this formula. So here PAT value is 180 crore, let's place it here, and the preferential dividend which is equal to 30 crore, let's place it here. And then finally divide it with the total number of issued shares, which are 1 crore. So the final values comes out to be 150 crore divided by 1 crore, and then EPS becomes rupees 150. So here we see that the earning per share is equal to rupees 150. That is, for each share, company is generating a profit of rupees 150. So now that we know the value of EPS and we know the meaning of earning per share, so let's move back to our question number 3 and let's see what is the correct answer. So moving back to our question, so now we know that the earning per share is rupees 150, hence option B becomes our correct answer. So it's time for us to move to our next question. So moving on to the next slide. So this question 4 is an extension of previous question, that is question number 3. So the data remains same. So IDFC Limited has a PAT of rupees 180 crore in the financial year 18-19, and the preference dividend payable is rupees 30 crore. Total number of issued share are 1 crore and the market price of share is 2250. And we need to calculate the P multiple of the company, that is price to earning ratio of the company. We have been given with 5 options. Option A says 15, option B says 1.5, option C says 30, option D says 0.3, and option E says none of the above. So exactly like the previous set of 2 questions, in the previous question we discarded this value of price value of share, that is 2250. In this question, this data will be relevant in order to calculate the PE multiple of the company. So give it a try and then cross check your answers in the upcoming slide. So resuming back, so let's move on to the explanation section to learn something more about this question. So moving on to the next slide, let's first bring back our question. Okay, we have got it. So before even calculating the PE multiple of a company or PE ratio of a company, let's know what exactly PE means. So PE means the price to earning ratio, which is a ratio for valuing a company that measures its current market price or current share price relative to its per share earning. And this earning is also sometimes known as price multiple or earnings multiple. So basically what this ratio is trying to tell you is that what is the price that an individual is willing to pay for 1 rupee earned from investing into that stock. And when it comes to the formula of PE ratio, it is equivalent to current market price divided by earning per share. So let's calculate the PE multiple of IDFC First Limited. So here in this PE ratio, we know that current market price is 2250. Let's place it here. And the earning per share we have calculated in the previous question, that is rupees 150. And the fun part, let's slash out the zeros in numerator and denominator and even slash out the requisite units, and then we come out to the final ratio, that is PE ratio is equal to 15. So now that we know the meaning of PE ratio and we have calculated the value of PE ratio, let's move back to our question and mark the correct answer. So as we know that the value of PE multiple is 15, so here option A becomes our correct answer. So it's time for us to move to our next question and to the next slide. So as per question number 5, given below is the following data of XYZ Enterprises Limited, and we need to calculate the absolute liquid ratio. So this is one of the liquidity ratio, and the data is given in this table, and we have also been given with 5 options. Option A says 0.5, option B says 2, option C says 1, and option D says 4, and E says none of the above. So clearly by reading out this question, you can get to a fact that this question is coming out from the ratio analysis portion of the finance syllabus. And if your concepts and understanding related to that part are pretty thorough, this question will be a cakewalk for you. So let's learn something more about this question in the explanation section. So moving on to the next slide. So let's first bring back our question. Okay, we have got it. So in this question, we have been given with certain data and we need to calculate the absolute liquid ratio. So this absolute liquid ratio is also known as cash ratio or super quick ratio. And this is equal to cash plus marketable securities. And this sum is when divided by current liabilities, we arrive at this absolute liquid ratio. So now let's place the values in the correct places in this formula. So we have cash of 115,000. Let's place it here. And then we have marketable securities of rupees 85,000. We need to place them here. And then the current liabilities are given worth of rupees 4 lakh, and these can be placed here. So after solving this whole thing, we'll arrive at absolute liquid ratio resulting to 0.5. This can also be written in the form 1 by 2. I'm just saying this because if in option the fraction is mentioned, you can even mark that also correct. So by solving this question, you might realize that this question was very easy one. In fact, it was. The only tricky part was that you need to identify the correct values from the table and then put it into the formula. So now that we know the value of absolute liquid ratio, let's move back to our question and mark the correct answer. So now we know that the absolute liquid ratio is 0.5 or 1 by 2. So here option A becomes our correct answer. So in this slide, I've collated all the answers. You can cross-check your answers if you want to. So that's it guys for this video. If you want to know more about EduTap, you are welcome to log on to www.edutap.co.in. If you have any queries, please drop them at hello@edutap.co.in. We'll be more than happy to address them. You can even contact us on this mentioned mobile number through call or WhatsApp. So if you found the content of this video to be helpful and informative, please don't forget to hit that like button. And for receiving continuous updates regarding the new videos being uploaded, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon next to it. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Happy learning. Bye-bye.